Guys, it's another day down here in the office, and I'm excited to say that we have a lot to do on eBay today. First of all, you guys remember in the last video that we did wrap up the death pile, but I may have manipulated that title just the tiniest bit. Okay, like, we really did wrap up the death pile. Like, that stuff's all done. However, I do have one more item that's a laptop that I didn't do, so I guess technically it's not all done, but we have kind of finished it, so we're gonna finish that one off here, and then we're gonna move on to some video game stuff, some stuff that I recently picked up at a garage sale, some stuff that I recently picked up at the thrift store. Again, try to get all that stuff listed, and then we'll go from there and see if we even get into some games or whatever else might come our way today. Okay, so this table was what had my death pile on it, and as you can see, there's one more item, so we're starting with that one right now. The problem is, I think I may have mentioned this in the last video, but it's an older laptop with somebody's account still on it, and I can't figure out how to get their account off it or how to refresh it with a fresh OS, so we're going to try it here. But, yeah, I don't know, we're going to have to see how that goes. So I have a charger for it somewhere, we're going to try it out. Just booting it up at the moment, it does seem like it's working, so I'm excited to get into it. But yeah, I still have to find, like, a video or something as to how I can update the profile, because actually right now their profile picture just popped up. And that's not what we want. Okay, guys, just followed along a YouTube tutorial as to how to reset this MacBook, and I think it all went well. I got into the terminal settings under the OS, and we reset everything. So now I'm just waiting for it to boot back up. We'll get it into an operating system, and we'll be ready to sell this guy. This is quite fun, guys. We're getting a whole intro into the new operating system here, but it does look like it worked.
Guys, I interrupt this program to tell you that I think we just played ourselves. So I'm in the process of getting this MacBook set up. I think it's actually done now. I just went ahead and installed the new OS and got that all set up. So that's good and it's working. You guys might remember in the last video we listed this red Xbox 360 as not working. Well, a buyer had asked us what was wrong with it and they wanted to pay full price, and it turns out that they actually just went ahead and bought it anyway. So I figured just because they bought it, I'll try it out and see if I can tell them if it's red ringed or whatever. I plug it in, right? I turn it on, no problem. I try to open the disc tray, it's stuck, but that's pretty common with these Xboxes. So I give it a little tap, we get it open, I put a disc in it, that works. AV works, I get it up on here, it works. Plug a controller and it works. So as far as I can tell so far, this thing works perfectly fine. And if it does work perfectly fine, there's no reason why we can't get $200 to $300 for it. So I'm not sure why we list this as is. I have all the parts here that I could use to put it back together, but we literally just sold a $300 thing for $85. I'm kind of hoping now that maybe it overheats here if I leave it running for 10 minutes. It is running a little bit loud, but other than that, I'm very surprised here. I don't know what's going on. The guy that we bought it from literally said that the Xbox in it was toast and then we need to swap it with another one. So I didn't even bother testing it. And here we are now.
Okay, so I left the Xbox running for about 10 minutes now, guys, and it does seem to be working fine. I left a message to the buyer to say basically that it does seem to be working, that the only problems are that it might have an overheating issue and that the disc tray wasn't opening right away, which is a common problem that I could have fixed if I had known, but whatever. So that buyer just got a really good deal. It just got basically working Resident Evil Xbox for $80. It's worth about $250. So anyway, that's all good, whatever. You know, we didn't know if it worked, we literally thought it didn't, so what else can we do? We can't waste our time testing everything that we know or think doesn't work. So anyway, I did just finish testing this guy right here. This is a receiver that I picked up. The brand on it is whatever that says, I actually don't know. But anyway, I'm not familiar with this one. I picked it up at a garage sale for I think $10, and I don't know, we'll see what it's worth. I just drafted it up, I have not looked up the value of it. In fact, I might do that here for a quick second just to see, but it does fully work and has been drafted now. Oh, and also the laptop has been drafted now as well. I got all the specs written out and put that all up in a draft, so that stuff is all done. Okay, I actually just gave this one a quick look up because I was curious, and there are a couple listed in like the 170 range, which is not bad at all. And I checked the solds, as low as 80, as high as about 150, so not bad there at all. We're probably gonna sell it for $100 and we'll be happy with that. So I'm happy about that. Now, this is a heavy unit and receivers are. This is about 12.5 kilograms, plus we're gonna need a box and whatnot and some packing material. We'll probably be closer to 14, 15 when we're done, but it's gonna be fine. We're just gonna make sure that we pack it really well and we should be good to go. So next up, you guys, I'm gonna list a couple Wii consoles for sale. I think we have three more, and then this one right here, which I've actually pulled out a bunch of stuff to make a bundle for. I grabbed the nicest unit I could find. This unit we paid $19.99 for. We can usually get between 30 and 40 for a Wii console only, but when you bundle them up like this, we tend to get a little bit more. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this sticker off it. We have a much nicer looking unit there. But yeah, $20 for that. I paid $7 for this wheel and remote the other day, and I already have one from another bundle. I've got a copy of Mario Kart that I saved for this very purpose, and then I've got some cables. So we're gonna go ahead and test this guy all, make sure it works. But if this all works, we should be looking at maybe 80 to 100, I'm thinking. Yeah, that should be good. Okay, so I'm just going through some of the remotes right now, trying to get them working. It looks like they both had corrosion damage, both purchased from totally separate places, but it just goes to show that these are some of the most common controllers to have this issue. Xbox 360 as well, I guess. against any ones that use a battery for that matter. But as you can see here, it's a little bit less obvious, but on that one there, we have a little bit of corrosion damage. And there, I mean, I did give them a good clean, so that's why you're not seeing it, but it was pretty nasty when I broke into them. This one also has a little bit here and there. Now, I just put some working batteries, these are brand new, into this guy right here, and I think I finally just got a signal. So occasionally, if you play around with it enough, it will work. I'll give it another compressed air spray and give it another clean, but that one should be good. This one, however, I still can't get any response from, so I'm gonna go and see if I have another one. If not, we may have to stall this lot out again, which I really don't want to do. Okay, good news, guys. I did just find another remote that we had. I had one third-party one that I was gonna throw in, but then at the last second, I found this one, which is awesome. So we have that one and then this one right here. So I'm gonna bundle these two with this unit, and we should be good to go. I guess I should probably test the console as well. But as for usual, they always work. These things, like, always work. I think we've only had like one come in that doesn't work. In fact, I think I have it here somewhere. Yeah, right there. And it was to do with the disk drive. So I guess that's maybe the one thing to look out for. But the remote's all sunk up really nicely. I've got still the wheels here. I've got everything hooked up. So we are gonna be good. I'm just gonna test the game now. I actually already tested the game, it works, but I just want to test the reader more so on this console, and then we're good to go. I'll give it a factory reset. We'll be able to sell this guy for hopefully some good money. All right, guys, so I finished testing on everything here, so we're gonna go ahead now and get this all listed, and I think this should sell fast. Okay, guys, we're on to another Wii now. This was another one that I have complete with cables. I just kind of made up with extra cables I have. And this is from Value Village. We paid $19.99 for it, and I had this extra set of controllers. This is kind of my last controller set here, other than going into like a no-name one, which we don't really like using because they tend to just break. But we're going to try this one here, see if any of this stuff works. But so far, so good. Actually, we can check right now. A free game in it. It doesn't look like it. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and give this guy a full test, and we'll list this one. I have two more Wiis here, guys, that I want to get listed. And these ones are just going to be listed as console only. I do not have any more controllers or cables, or at least not complete sets. So it's going to be easier just to list these guys as console only. I'm going to let some Goo Gone set in here. Gonna get that sticker off it, and then we'll be good to go. Okay, guys, so both the Wiis have now been listed. The only difference or change that I made was I went ahead and I took the cover off of one of them and I put it on this one, so we have one complete one, then one that was missing covers. We won't get barely anything for this one, but it was also missing the screws. Sometimes I might order a cover, but it's got the screws missing, and that makes it a little bit of a mess because it could have been opened or whatever. We'll list it as working because I tested it as working, but I'm going to mention all those details in the description, so hopefully we'll be okay with that. But this one works very well and is in very nice shape. So we've got both those guys done, and let's move on to whatever else we're doing today. Now, next up, guys, I have a couple Xbox 360 S's that I want to get listed, and these guys I'm going to list as just console only, as I was going to wait and bundle them up. However, I don't have any power adapters for them. I do have some remotes and probably some AV kicking around, but you don't really need AV for these anyway because they're HDMI consoles. But yeah, no power adapters, and I don't feel like waiting, so I'm going to list them now. If they sell, great. If not, then I'll just wait until we get another power adapter in, and then, of course, we can do a bundle, just take one down and bundle it with a power adapter. But until we get another one or find one at VV or get one in extra in a bundle, then these guys, there's just no point in them sitting. Let's get them listed and hopefully make some quick money for them. Hey, guys, so I just wrapped up listing these two Xbox 360s, and with that, we have a really nice pile of things I'm going to be able to run to the unit now. This is everything that we've listed in the last couple days, a couple MacBooks, I don't know, a couple consoles here and there, whatever the case, a lot of the stuff we did today, some of it we did in the video that I made before today's, but I'm very excited that we have all this stuff done now, and it's nice to get all this stuff out of here. So we still have more to do. To my right, I'm not going to show it to you guys yet, but we have a ton of video game boxes that arrived that I'm very excited to get into. However, this is a good start for now, and I'm excited to get all this stuff out of here. Yeah, good work. Okay, guys, so unfortunately, that's all the time I have today for listing stuff. Some of those items took a little bit longer than I thought, especially testing all those Wiis, but luckily they're all done now and listed, which is fantastic. Now, I did want to pitch you guys on a quick idea here. Something I've been thinking about, and specifically when it comes to consoles, is when we get a lot of the consoles in, what we have is usually some sort of piece missing, whether it be an AV cable, a power cable, a remote's not working, whatever it is, and we always end up having to order an extra part and wait for it to arrive, or we keep our eyes out at Value Village. And that's actually where a lot of the consoles came from today that we listed. They were extra consoles that we were sitting around waiting to make bundles with. Now, sometimes if we don't have anything for a bundle, we'll just do what I did today and list them as consoles only. But occasionally, if we have like half a bundle, we like to wait until we have a full bundle so we can get the most amount of money for the item. Now, one of the things I was recently thinking about doing is potentially, instead of only buying things when we need them, for example, right now, if we get a PS2 in and we're missing an AV cable, what I do is I go on eBay or wherever and I order an AV cable for a PS2. Instead of doing it that way a la carte, What if instead we basically bulk ordered a parts department? So here we might have, you know, a ton of PS2 AV cables, a bunch of PS2 power cables, a bunch of Wii AV cables, Wii power cables, different remotes. And these can be stocked, you know, through wholesale or whatever, whether we buy things on eBay or whatever, replacement ones, OEM ones, whatever it might be, whatever's most affordable. Or it could be stocked through us going to Value Village and finding cables and things there. But I think having an area dedicated to kind of organizing all the different things and knowing what we have for consoles so we can just see everything at once. Right now, they're kind of separated in different bins, which is a pain to know what we actually have and what we don't have. But I think if we had a very organized parts department in terms of basically just having cables and controllers on hand to make bundles with, it might make our lives a lot simpler. And also, it increases our turnover because when we get a console, we can literally sell it right away because we have all the cables and controllers we need. We can pull them right away and get it going versus waiting like, you know, 7 to 15 days for a cable to come in so we can list that item. Just a thought, let me know what you guys think. And if you do anything like that, do you guys order cables and extra parts? Or even if you're fixing other things or whatever you're selling, and if it's missing something, do you just order them as you need them? Or is it something that you have a bunch of on hand so you can just grab them and you're ready to go? I think as we start to scale up more and we're doing more and more consoles and more different things, it might be easy to have some here on hand. And it doesn't have to be a lot, but even just have 5 of each cable or even less, just a few of them, and then be able to reorder them when we run out, might be a good way to stay a step ahead of the game. Anyway, guys, with that little idea out of the way, let me know what you think down below in the comment section. I'm going to end today's video here. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it and found some value in it. If you did, be sure to go below and smash the like button on this video. Again, comments, questions, concerns down below. I'll try to get back to you guys as quickly as I can. Subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I'll see you guys all in the next video.